Good evening to all the participants, present on here, and I thank all the two participants, that is presenters, who have suggested for me and give the opportunity. Thank you very much. And actually, I'm going to present a small topic, which is going to be useful only for the engineering level students, not in the developing side or all this. So then here the topic which I am going to present is how to connect a Python program using a MySQL database. So this is up to the engineering level only, cannot expect more than that in this level. So I am going to tell about how to create a database and how to connect the MySQL database with the Python programming. Once you connect the implementation, and you can easily get the data, and you can extend your logic for any topic, any logic.
No, just you keep pressing it until you find what.
So now I'm implementing the Python program with the help of the CGI. So I'm making this generally the MySQL database is said to be three-tier architecture. And when you want to interact with the program, you must get some input from the user. For that, I am using HTML program as a interaction between you program as well as the user. Then using HTML program, I'm going to read the values. Then all the database, everything I'm storing in the second tier, that is MySQL database. Then with the help of the CGI program, that is my third tier, I'm going to extract the data which is there in the MySQL database. So this, and when, suppose you can connect MySQL with Python, Perl also can be connected with MySQL database. Similarly, PHP can also be connected with the MySQL database. Here I'm using CGI as a tool which connects MySQL database and going to database. First of all, you must know how to the basic steps. You are aware of all this. You have to connect to the MySQL connectivity. First step is MySQL. To get the MySQL prompt, you have to give the command as MySQL-U. And next, while you'll be getting a MySQL prompt, then create a table. And this you'd have studied in Oracle, all this. Now, next is you are going to this till now we have created database. The database is empty now. Now, for next, I'm going to read the values. For reading a value from the users, I'm going to use the HTML forms only. So this form, I'm reading name as well as session number. That's it. Okay, then I am creating a submit button. So now as soon as you enter, it is like a student result web portal. As soon as you give the register number, it will show the status of the result of a particular register number. That's it. For doing this, I'm using HTML programming to read the inputs. So this program is meant for reading a register number and once you read the register number, click a submit button. And now after, as soon as you click a submit button, it will tell you the status of the student. How many subjects in which he cleared and how many subjects in which he is not cleared. Now, the third one is, this is my program. So, import CGI concept, as I told earlier, I'm using CGI as a front-end tool for implementation. And of the print content type is HTML and all this, then import MySQL database. Next is you have to create a create a connectivity, then open a database. Then generally the thing which you cannot do in SQL or MySQL databases, at a time you can access a single set of rows. So you cannot in Oracle, as similar to MySQL, you can fetch a single row only. Suppose if you want to fetch multiple rows, and the alternate method is you have to make a cursor concept only. So cursor is nothing but a memory area in which you can access multiple rows at a time. So suppose in PLSQL program and all, we know very well you cannot make a command like select star from table name. If you use this, yes, So now for that only I am creating a database and I am using the cursor to select. So now opening the cursor and fetching the values. Next is once the you are entering the resident number, once the resident number is correct, now it will go into fetch the data. For printing the data, I am using the CJ program. So all these are, now again you have to check whether the student is passed or not. Generally the student scores greater than 50 or more than that, he is assumed that he is passed in the subject, otherwise he failed in the subject. For all this, I am writing the algorithm. Next is you have to, now this is your program, now your STM program is ready, database is also ready, now you have to execute the program. For doing that, you have to open a, actually I implemented this in BOSS operating system, Bharat operating system solution. Okay, so this, I'm using MySQL also. So if you enter the value, it will ask you to register a number. The answer is, the register number is there, now it is showing the results, whether the student has passed in all the subjects or not. This is one category. Suppose another is, if the register number is not found and not present, then you have to say that the student number is not there in the database. That's it. Okay, so now here, I'm using three-tier architecture. One is the STM platform to read the values, and MySQL is the second tier, and my use of CJ program to interaction with the database as well as solve this. This is my concept, and this will be useful in engineering level students only, not more than that. Thank you for the participants. Thank you.